emotions can be gained by understanding the stimulus response pattern. When you have certain experiences, you respond with various emotions. Stimulus response. Just as this sort of stimulus produces this sort of involuntary muscular response. Well, that's a rather simplified suggestion of a complex mental process, but you get the idea. Cause, effect. Nature endows us at birth with three general patterns of emotional response. Rage is the response to the primary stimulus of thwart, something interfering with our behavior, our action. Fear is the response to loud noises or loss of support. And the emotional response to love is usually the result of a show of affection or favor. And these seem to be the emotions with which we start life. Then as we grow up, many everyday things and social situations become associated with these primary stimuli, partly by a process called conditioning. And so many things in people cause us to respond emotionally. And in general, that's good.
Or decreases efficiency personality.
See what I mean?
See what I mean?
And of course, it's the fault of the wrench. This is called projection. He's projecting the blame to the wrench. Well, we've seen Jeff lose control of himself in rage. Let's see how the rest of the family is doing.
Let's take a look at Mike's everyday life. To understand how to come to the crime and bring it home.
I'm glad.
Roberts says that he plans to restore faith in government by restoring the government's faith in the people. Now, statewide race, metro counties made all the difference. Garrett Hake shows us the surprising results that swung the election for the Republicans.
So the 105 counties in Kansas, but when you came on down, three counties in all of the Union area decided how this election was going to go and really made all the difference. Two of them went about like we expected, but maybe not by the margins that the Democrat and Republican needed. This is Wyandotte County off the coast. This is traditionally a fairly strong Democratic county with a heavy minority vote in that area. Greg Warman, 64%. Paul Davidson, a little bit better, 66%. If you're looking at this early in the night, you think that's probably okay, but it may not be enough. And as the results started to come in from around the state, that turned out to be the case. Look at Douglas County. This is another typically very strong Democratic area of the state. When you go into the vote there, you see Greg Warman getting 67% of the vote there. Paul Davis getting 72% of the vote. This is where you start to see a lot of trouble for Greg Warman. He needs to track with Paul Davis all night long. If he's going to win that Senate seat, they need to be lined up. They need to be bringing home all of those Democratic voters in addition to Republicans and Independents. So when you see this kind of numbers in Douglas County, you knew that Greg Warman was...
amazing year of enjoying the Father's goodness and love. Have a blessed year.
I tell you tonight, after studying this book for 20 years, there is no other name given among men whereby we must be saved except the name of Jesus. There is no other way of salvation. I despise all the attention on me. I wish we could publicize the meetings in some way with my name or not.